Hey, good morning, family. It's Tuesday and June 2nd, and I wanted to finish up really what we've been talking about, and that is the sower sows the word, and going into the explanation there on that scripture. So let me just read that to you. And so in Mark chapter 4, verses 13 through 20, Jesus said this, explained this parable of the sower sowing the word. And he said, "Do you not understand this parable? How then will you understand all the parables? The sower sows the word, and these are the ones by the wayside where the word is sown. When they hear, Satan comes immediately and takes away the word that was sown in their hearts. These likewise are the ones sown on stony ground, who, when they hear the word, immediately receive it with gladness, and they have no root in themselves, and so endure only for a time. Afterward, when tribulation or persecution arises for the word's sake, immediately they stumble or get offended. Now these are the ones sown among thorns. They are the ones who hear the word, and the cares of this world, the deceitfulness of riches, and the desires for other things entering in, choke the word, and it becomes unfruitful." And then in verse 20, the part we've been waiting to get to, "But these are the ones sown on good ground, those who hear the word, accept it, and bear fruit, some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100. And so the scripture that I've been using as an example for this parable of the sower sowing the word is Proverbs chapter 10, verse 22. Okay, so I'm going to read that to you in New King James Version, and it says, "The blessing of the Lord makes one rich, and he adds no sorrow with it." Okay, and so we explained earlier about how the devil comes to steal the word right away, how he comes, you expect to get a blessing because you just heard this, the blessing of the Lord makes you rich, so you're expecting to get some money in the mail, or you're expecting to get a notice that something got paid off, and instead you get another bill or a bill you weren't expecting, and you go, "Oh man, you know, this doesn't work." All right, and so, or then yesterday we talked about the deceitfulness of riches, where you're desiring things and money and thinking that the money or the things will take care of you and make your life so wonderful, rather than recognizing that the blessing is in place so that you can be a blessing. And so we talked about that. So now, good ground, 30, 60, 100-fold. And so what happens is this word, and I've already talked about how you have to sow the word, and you have to see it, you say it, you hear it, you plant it. You see it, you say it, you hear it, you plant it. So this word, the more you read this, the more you meditate on this, the more you get this deep down on the inside of you, "The blessing of the Lord makes me rich, and he adds no sorrow with it." The more that begins to happen, then what goes on the inside, and we talked about when we first started this, the sower sows the word, and we went to John chapter 1, and it says, "In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God." So the word gets sown into you. The blessing of the Lord makes you rich. So that gets on the inside of you, and it starts to do things, changing the way that you think and the way that you approach different things. So rather than being afraid of promotion, or rather than being nervous about maybe stepping out, you begin to think, "Well, the blessing of the Lord makes me rich, and so I can do this." And you start to see things happen. One of the things that I can think about that's happened in my life is my desire to just do a little extra at work, to do a little more at work. And you say, "Well, everybody could do that." Yeah, everybody can. But if you don't have something working on the inside of you that changes you from just going in and punching the clock and punching out, going in, do what you got to do, bare minimum, and then get out, that's what you do. But as you start to meditate on this, you start to think, "Hey, you know what? If I was the business owner, what would I do? If I own this business, how would I want people to work for me," right? And then you start to think, "How can I own my own business?" Then you start to get ideas and concepts and innovations, and you start to do things that brings, the blessing starts to bring riches. It just starts to change the way that you're thinking up here. You start thinking a better way and you start doing better. So you think better, you do better. And so the blessing of the Lord makes you rich and he has no sorrow with it. You also start to think about how you can be a blessing. Before you think about more yourself and what you can do for you, but as the blessing of the Lord gets in there and starts stirring up these ideas, it also starts to stir up in you the reason why the blessing is there. It's so that you can be a blessing. And so you start to think about how can you bless other people. So this 30, 60, 100-fold return begins to start working in your life, and you start to see you take care of paying off your bills, you start getting your debts paid off, you start saving money, you start investing money, and you give, and you love to give, and you want to give. And it's just the way that the Bible works. Don't get mad at me. Don't get upset. But it's just the way that the Bible works. When you give, you get it back. When you give, it's given back. I think Jesus said this. No, I know Jesus said this. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. So it's just the way that it works with God. When you give, it's given back to you. And so you start to develop a desire to want to give, and you just start getting blessed, and then you can be more of a blessing, and it just keeps building on top of itself. It's like a snowball in a good way. So, all right. So that's the parable of the sower sows the word. I'll get with you tomorrow. I love you. Have a great day.